Everybody, welcome to Rethinking, Rebuilding, and Reinforcing Culture. Again, Jack Gottlieb, CEO with Total Solutions Group. Thank you so much for being here. Joe Urbanski, our COO, who you might remember as well, is with us due to the fact of everything, of course, going on. We're not able to physically be together, so I will be running this, but he is here with us. So thank you so much for being here, understanding these completely different times than when we initially set this up. So I really appreciate you being here. This certainly is not just about obviously following up from our session to provide further value and strategic and tactical support to you, but also contextually, how does this actually still can be a value to you with what we're all going through right now and what is constantly up and down and changing. In many ways, this is even more relevant now than ever. So just a couple quick things for you to support this. So for those of you that may not be familiar with Zoom, some quick housekeeping notes. On the top right corner, you'll see some buttons that are there that you can swap shared screen with video and enter full screen. So this just kind of allows you to maximize whether you want to see more of my pretty face or the PowerPoint. And you can certainly move things around to whatever you're comfortable with, but that gives you the flexibility to do that. And then on the bottom middle, you'll see three buttons. One, a chat button. Obviously, that allows you to kind of provide chat back to me. And it's a little functionality. I know Zoom is going through a couple issues right now, but in terms of their tech support, but I should be able to see your pieces because I am missing a little bit of a window bar here, but nonetheless, that should work just fine with the chat button. Q&A, certainly there as well. And we'll be giving you some options that beyond what we do during the session in terms of other questions, thoughts, or needs. Certainly we'll provide some avenues by which to support you offline with this as well. And then there is a button that you might see here that says raise hand. So just to make sure functionality that works, can you all just click that so I can see if that's working for everybody? It is perfect. We've got two people, three, four, five, all of us, beautiful. So as you might recall during our session, we did that quite often. That's not for being academic and treating you like you were back in school, but just making sure to keep the engagement going. So those are our pieces today. Obviously, we would be remiss if we didn't start off with this. So we all know that the coronavirus in many ways is pressing our national culture, our state culture, right? Our communities, our businesses, and in many ways, due to the constant news, the constant changes, market up, market down, right? If you were following the news, and we've been saying this to a lot of our clients as we've been supporting them, it's very easy to chase headlines versus chasing context, right? And there's so many things that are going on that obviously, regardless of everything going on, this is severe and something we all know we need to be aware, we need to prepare, but we need to try our best not to panic, and really provide that support to our employees, to our families. And culture is at the center of that, right? Because culture in many ways isn't just about, as we've talked about, the identity, the vision, mission, values, the meetings we do, the lanyards, the mugs, the events. You know, it's about how does that help us create unity even in times like this? So while this will be positioned to support, of course, the progressive nature that we all want to be on, and we will fully get back to, right? How can we still do that now? So I'm gonna balance that context throughout this. And as you've known throughout this, especially for us in the United States, it's only been 2.5 weeks. Doesn't it feel like that this has been going on for months? And so because of that, how do we make sure that we can both kind of learn from and use kind of what we're going through as a lens by which that we can better represent ourselves and our organization? Right. So, all right. So with that being said, I want you to do is push your chair back. Right. You might recall the wave, don't you? Yes. I know we can't see each other. Yes. I know. Oh, you're raising your hand already. We all remember the wave. Perfect. Right. So what I want you to do is we're going to do the wave right now. Now we can't hear each other. We can't see each other. This is a virtual shared trust wave. Right. So on the count of three, we're going to just do this really cool. I've never done this before. Right. Count of three. We're all going to kind of push our chairs back, which hopefully we've already done. We're going to do the wave on the count of three. You ready? I'm going to pull myself a little farther back here. Ready? One, on three, two, three, go. Woo! Now, not knowing if some of you did it or did not, let's be honest, raise the hand on that little raised hand button. How many of you did do it, as silly as it may be, whether you're home or at work? most of us, all of us, beautiful, right? One more time, so thank you. Show of hands. How many of you was this even weirder than when we first did? Because now you're in your office, your home, and you're by yourself. You can't even hear this right now, right? So why did we do it? Well, first, as you might recall, this represents the unity and alignment of that cadence and rhythm of all being on the same page, right? All having, while we're different and unique in a sporting event or a concert, it's really that music, it's that band, it's that concert, it's that sports team that really brings us together because of a common core, similar to our culture. But we're virtual right now. Think about how, and by a show of hands, how many of you have virtual remote work right now? People are working remotely, right? And that's obvious, right? But I want to make sure some of us are having a more blended. Imagine how weird this was for you right now. How does this relate to our teams? How does this relate to our people in the sense of how do we keep them connected to the bigger purpose? In this case, we did the wave. Well, how do we get them to the bigger purpose that we can't physically always fully see, fully feel, fully touch, fully connect to? Think about that. And when it comes to remote work, when it comes to remote meetings, Microsoft Teams, Zoom, all mechanisms, right, are at our fingertips by which to make it easier, but that doesn't mean we're connected, right? So we're gonna talk about that. So let's do a quick kind of recap. What does culture need to be, right? A living, breathing, dynamic identity that defines your organization's purpose, direction, and values. Let's stop there. Now, the bigger identity by which that you as a learning and development function and you as an organization, we know that that is still critical even in this very ever-changing world that we're in right now. But this can also be something that can be, I don't want to say week to week, but hear me on this, can evolve week to week or month to month so that we are framing an identity that can build and grow. Even if it's taking what we've already got as an organization, an L&D function, you don't have that right now. That's some of the reasons why you came. How do we create a living, breathing, dynamic identity that supports what we do now? And there'll be more follow-up that we'll be sending out to not only our clients and you and the bigger community that we network and support starting next week with some more value added. But I share this with you now to say, this isn't about, oh, we're so crazy right now, we can't do this. No, we can do this now because last part now, it is about empowering your people to take ownership, make decisions, to drive forward what your organization needs, right? And think about this. There is so much information coming at us. How many of you, by a show of hands, agree that there is, even though this is real, there is more panic than necessarily real kind of understanding in our society right now? A lot of you are raising your hands, right? Because of that, we need to own that narrative that helps support and shape your organization support, right? So as a result of that, that's something that is really critical for us as we go forward here. So a couple key things just as we recap here. One, this is all about transforming the L&D culture and strategy from program-based to results-based. Even in what you may be doing right now that is now more virtual or more intentional in the sense of trying to provide support to people, we can still do that. Even if we're only spending 20 minutes of time a day because we're trying to create something for folks, we don't have the hours or days or mini sessions that maybe we were planning right now. And this applies both ways. How do we really do that? Two, we've got to make sure that what we're doing here to be this world-class function, even right now, that we're developing a blueprint for growth, capability, and sustained progression. Even if it is day to day, how do we still make sure what we're providing people and that comfort and support is impactful for them? Three, most critically, how do we build and facilitate an experience to empower everyone to take ownership, right? And that's huge right now in what we're doing and what we're dealing with in support. I do know, just because Joe would share with me, if you have been using the chat function, I'm not seeing anything right now. I don't know, we've done a lot of Zoom webinars. That might not be, I haven't said anything yet, that's fine. But know that if I don't respond to anything, it could be something wrong with the functionality. I know they are over inundated right now with requests. So I ask you just to be patient. If you are submitting questions or chat, I'm not seeing anything. Typically we would. So Joe, I know you can hear me. Just submit a chat or a question while I'm going forward just to see if that pops on my screen. So thank you for balancing with me here. So you might recall this path, right? Who we are, what we want to be and accomplish, and how we're going to get there. right? This is a blueprint of key mindsets, key tools, key approaches that when you pull it together, really represents not just our path, but strategically and tactically how we really create value, right? And opportunity to support what is needed today. I'll give you a quick example of that actually. So you might see this book here. This is one of our clients, Bankwest. They've been around for, now this was written in 2014, kind of their history. So it says 131 years they've been in existence. Their history is just as critical to what we are transforming and shaping for them right now, not just because of respect, but there's a lot that they want to maintain. There's a lot that we want to make sure doesn't change, or people do know when they get hired, when they start that new job or new role. So point I'm making with this is each of these pieces represents just a part of the story, right? And something that real critically is we sent in the follow-up a few weeks ago with this path, what we did in that immersive workshop, how do you start to leverage this? Even if right now, with all that's going on, but we want to still do this, even if right now it's 2 to 3 bullet points in each, so that we give people that sense of faith and trust in who we are, when right now the news, the narrative, and the headlines is taking us out of our comfort zone, taking us off a path of a trust and faith. We can easily repackage, even as an L&D function, training department, how do we represent ourselves in a very quick and agile way using this blueprint of support, right? So it's just some context, not just to make this about today's situation, but certainly shapes the future as well. So to give you a quick example and then just get some interaction here for a bit. And not seeing anything chat forward just yet. So Joe, if you did share something, I'm not seeing it. So this may change a bit our interaction here, since for whatever reason that function is not, you sent 4 messages, Joe said. Okay. Don't know why those are not coming up. So not sure. So I apologize for that and trying to see what's not working here, but we'll just have to play with this kind of as is right now, just to keep moving our time. So Johnson Controls, one of our clients. So their global vision mirrors the organization's vision, which is the power behind your mission and strategy. So for the L&D function, we fully power the mission and strategy of our customers by implementing innovative solutions that bring technology and employee performance to work seamlessly in their business. This is about being the power behind not just the classes, not just the programs, not just the needs, right? But here's where this really takes shape. I'm gonna give you a situational example that will leverage against this. So their mission is based on 3 parts. 1 for the business. We are a learning business that is aligned to and empowers the mission of JCI, Johnson Controls. We're not just a learning department that trains people. Think about that mindset shift that in the mission, this is how we want to be day to day. How does that shape how you want to be for the business right now? How you want to create a sense of trust and confidence in what's going on and how we want to represent ourselves. Stakeholders, right? The business leaders, the business unit leaders, people that are obviously invested into you. We have a permanent seat at our stakeholders' table, but we also want our stakeholders at our table because of our understanding within and across the business units. It's that mindset of we are an equal part of, and that's how we're shaping our partnerships and relationships with our stakeholders. Lastly, our customers, we know your business. We add real value beyond your expectations. We share and own in your successes and challenges. So in the end, we drive results that matter. This is a roadmap that is helping them right now situationally deal with what is going on in the world with clients, within the organization, because it's a guidepost that says on a daily, weekly basis, how do we use it to shape how we need to think about today, how we need to respond with what comes today, so that while we're flexible, we're still leading in this based on who we are, right? Where we're looking to go and how we need to get there. So while, again, I apologize that we are not having chat work right now, and I don't know why, so that loses the interaction on this. And I do apologize because I'm not sure why. What I will then just ask you for to think about is this. What have you worked on or thought about since our session? If you've worked on or thought about things but said, oh, I don't have time for this right now. We're gonna talk about that in a little bit. Because what is going on today, you can still leverage this to support as I've started to give you examples to. Now think about how is what we're doing here even more relevant today in what is going on in our world and within your organization? So obviously in the absence of the interaction, I'm asking you to think about that. With what I've just went through is kind of a setting the stage and recapping what we've done, what are you starting to realize? What are you starting to see? What is it that maybe is empowering to you about this? And we'll prompt based on the emails we'll ask you for just to leverage your insights and action, sending that to us so we can support that. So in the absence of that, let's talk about some real-time application with this. So raise hands. How many of you have played Monopoly before? How many of you remember the game Monopoly? And that little raise hand button, thank you so much. Right? This game actually teaches one of the most fundamental business lessons today that frankly, we didn't even realize at the time. So remember Monopoly? What was the goal? Now, the goal, if we are honest with ourselves, is bankrupting people. Now, I'm having some fun with you, right? But it was to get the most money and have everybody else kind of leave out of that game. But how did we win? There were three steps. Acquire properties, right? Boardwalk, Park Place, Ventnor. I'm forgetting some of the other ones, even though we just played Monopoly with myself and my kids. That's pretty bad of me, but we know Boardwalk, Park Place, right? Get the properties. And when people landed on the properties, though, what happened? You made money. As you made money, you started to build greenhouses. Each of those greenhouses increased your rent so you can make more money to get more greenhouses. And when you had four greenhouses, you could get one red hotel. How many of us remember that? Remember that? And that's you could charge a lot of money and make it even better, especially when you're on Boardwalk and Park Place, right? That's agile thinking. That's what real-time either transformation or building for the first time or progressing forward our culture, either organizationally or training, L&D, however you identify yourself, is about. It's not just about, well, because of the coronavirus and or even if this didn't happen, we got really busy, things change, I'm too busy, I can't work on this. Or I'm working on this and all right, I can't share this right now because it's not done. It's about while we work on it, we need to work in it. We're gonna talk about that in a minute. So Peggy Johnson, EVP of Business Development, was the very first hire that Satya Nadella hired when he first joined Microsoft in 2014. So there's a powerful clip here we're gonna share, which should work because we did tap this. But now I do see a Q&A that popped up here. So again, CEO Joe said, is this working? It is, I did see one Q&A pop forward, but the chat window for whatever reason is not working. So Joe, thank you for that. So I do see that at least questions are coming through. So thank you for that. And again, thank you for allowing me to kind of, oh, here's the chat window. It just popped up. All right, Zoom kind of caught up with us. Beautiful. And it's just a lot of yeses and yeps from the beginning. Perfect. Excellent. All right, so we are working here. Fantastic. All right. Hopefully that will continue. We'll see. So that being said, I'm going to share with you a video clip. And in this video clip, she talks about how the change in culture in Microsoft, based on a question that was asked, wasn't just a moment in time that people forgot, but how it's embedded. So enjoy this clip. Should work well, fingers crossed, based on what Zoom's going through. And we'll join back here in just a moment.
Peggy, this has been great. But I love this idea of going from a know-it-all culture to a learn-it-all culture. Now, you sort of described it. You said it was a spark, and once it happened, it spread like wildfire. And somehow, I suspect it wasn't quite that easy. And I think you got a lot of people in this room who, they all come from great companies. They wouldn't be here if they didn't come from great companies. They're all facing a transition mm-hmm. like the one you talked about. Can you talk a little more tactically
right.
about how you make that transition? Because it was a deep, deep culture at Microsoft.
It was, and you know, we have a lot of people, 130-some-odd thousand people, and to get that message all the way down through all the ranks, I mean, that's challenging to do, for sure. One thing that Satya talks about is consistency. So from the moment, you know, he was interviewing me until today, he's had this same message, and so the reinforcement of our mission statement to empower every person and organization on the planet to achieve more, people can repeat that from the top to the bottom. And our ambitions, it's just something that he starts every one of our internal all hands meetings, like our executive all hands, with that mission statement, with our ambitions. And he goes back to them and he ladders everything up to that. And that's helpful. And that's something he has advised companies who are undertaking their own transformations to be consistent in your messaging. Keep coming back to it. Keep revisiting it. It's something that, you know, you don't want to do a box check and put a sticker on the back of your name tag, and that's my mission statement. I never look at it again.
For how many of you was that very simple but powerful? In the sense that this is something that is about balancing what we do, but also how we do it, embedded in everything, right? So when you think about what we're talking about here, right, it's this unbelievably challenging reality, but a reality that when we walk on the other side, it's also the pathway to success. So it's that dual, you know, two sides of the sword, if you will, two sides of a coin, right? We always know we need a need. So have some fun with me here so we can interact here. So if you're typing or writing or doing things, shake out your hands like this. No, I can't see you, but I trust you. Put your fingers out like this. And first, I want you to say out loud or in your head, if there's people near you, I understand, like, what is he or she doing? We need to work on the business. So take your fingers and draw a circle like working on the business. Got it? So we first need to do what? Work on the business. You're right. But we also need to balance that with how we need to now put your fingers down, work in the business. So we first got to do what? Be mindful of how to work on the business and work in it. Exactly. So you heard from Peggy, right? This culture. If you remember when Satya first joined Microsoft, what was the first thing that was like, whoa, for those of us that were iPhone and are iPhone and iPad users, he finally was able to release Microsoft applications on the iOS platform and other platforms going forward. It was always the third party providers and it was never married. He was very committed and still is. It's about the sharing and connection of our technology, not protecting it, right? He was working on the business in that culture shift, but working in it at the same time because of, we gotta move the culture forward as if it's complete while we're working on it. That was the release 2 months in. He didn't wait for the whole vision and mission. You can see I'm having some fun with you here, although that was not intentional. You know, that whole, you know, again, who, what, how, right? That whole culture path. Yeah, there was a lot to work on, but what can we leverage now? And that's the one reality I want to support you with today is how do we really think about this now, right? While we're working on it. So this is a blueprint that you will get from us as a follow-up. Now, understanding is what has changed in the past 2.5 weeks. The idea of the long-term, I know, is extremely difficult. I want to still go through it with you because our long-term visions and strategies certainly will adjust, but we will as a society get through this. We will as a society grow from this. We will as a society certainly become stronger from this. And let me just say this as a quick note. Maybe some of you have gotten this on your respective Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, whatever social circles that you're a part of. There is a tremendous amount of opportunity that we can take advantage of in this time. One of which is our own development and growth in a way in which, and again, we're providing some value-added support to this that will go out to you via email, but also out to our bigger network, specifically on LinkedIn. But the idea of where can we grow and learn that even if we are still fully working or if work has been somewhat adjusted in our space, and I know for some of you in the industries that we're in, if it's certainly Universal or theme parks in general, right? Or cruises, et cetera, that's really shifted. Well, what can we work on? What can we do? What can we leverage for ourselves, for our team, so that we can better ready and prepare and improve so that we're even more set up for success, right? So let me just want to take a step back to do that because we do have that opportunity, even though we still have to deal with all these challenges. So working on the business, what's the path by which for you, whether it's partly now or waiting past this to go forward with. So at the core, there's three key steps that you want to be cognizant about. First, the setup. You want to think about having at least a C-suite leader, representation from the regions if you're in different regions of either this country or the world. We want to have that represented. Functionally, backstage, your accounting, your legal, your HR. Front stage, customer service, R&D, engineering, QA, compliance, just giving examples here. All of us are different. Cooks, you know, whatever that might be, waitresses, waiters, et cetera, right? Backstage, front stage, customer facing, right? So just those aspects of it. Leadership level, so having representation where it makes sense at different leadership levels, and just background of folks, right? Folks that may have just joined the organization, folks that certainly have different just overall backgrounds, whether that's from an ethnic standpoint, belief standpoint. Again, this doesn't mean you need 45 people in a group. It really is about just having a representation that, as much as you can, having this represented, and that could still only be 5 to 7 people, right? It could be a task force right now that you're still working on this, but for the value of what's going on today. And we'll get to that in a second. Team alignment. We want to understand whoever is working with you on this, their passion, their vision for the organization themselves. What do they see? And then the approach, which again, working on it, working in it. We'll get to the work in it in a second. This is the framework you want to think about. This is very built upon kind of that hackathon, agile methodology, sprint methodology, right? And how do we really move things forward? You want to build it, you want to test it, you want to soft launch it, we want to refine and launch it. You can do this on a daily basis. You could build a piece of the puzzle that we're trying to, again, leverage not just for our future, but because of what's going on, you know, to the present. And this allows us with, let's say if it is 5 to 7 people, what do we want to build in terms of, for example, our massive transformative purpose, right? You might recall that is one of the pieces we did immerse into as part of our workshop, the value follow-up I sent to you with all the key pieces that you worked on in those flip charts. You had that as a model, as an example. But you may say, well, let's build that MTP for us right now over the next 3 months. Think about that, right? So I'm getting a little bit into work in it, but I'm just giving this as an example. You can build something for the benefit of how we're gonna learn it and build the confidence and capability of our organization in these times of change. Maybe that's your kind of bigger vision and the bigger purpose is that we come out stronger on the other side, right? Just giving that as an example. You can build that, you can test it. Let's talk to some key stakeholders or people underneath our key people. Let's soft launch that. We're gonna leverage this out as a weekly piece with key tips and ideas. We're gonna leverage this with our webinars or training that we're gonna do. So everything is anchored around that, just as we heard with Microsoft, right? You get value, you get insights, you refine it, and maybe it's something that we launch and support. That's what that means. That's the core, whether it's long-term or short-term, how we need to approach it. So again, you can morph this based on your reality. What does this look like in terms of building and activating in year one? Because it takes 2 years to do this right. Well, you want 90-day sprints. So your first sprint is that stakeholder assessment and roadshow, going to, more than likely virtually right now, going to each stakeholder and saying, for example, based on what we're dealing with right now, where and how do you see our culture, or if it's just learning and development culture, what's most critical to you and what we need to represent for this organization to ensure we are building the confidence, the resiliency, the capability of our people? What's most critical to you? What do we need to do? What shouldn't we do? How do we go forward? Just giving that to you as a generic example. You want to travel, do some virtual meetings. You can do it just with all that's going on right now in 15-minute little burst with people, knowing that we need more time on the bigger end of this. You can do that. And then you're providing all those insights together that maybe is 3 to 4 bullet points from each person and bringing that together to provide direction to the organization to say, here's our bigger purpose. Here's our bigger vision and mission as the L&D department. Here's how this connects to our current reality and the future that we want to get to. As a result, here's the top insights based on these questions that we've asked. We're providing direction, providing confidence. We're like Johnson Controls for what we're building with them. They're getting a seat at our table, not just a seat, we're having a seat at their table, right? That's really key because assessment, validation, alignment is really critical. Then we start to get into that first or that second sprint, which is who we want to be. That's that culture path that we talked about. Those are those key pieces to start to build with our key group, test with those key folks that are represented by that key ad hoc group, and really start to test in a way that we can then soft launch. We get value. What project, what situation, what area can we soft launch this in so that we're getting real value out there, not just in who we want to be, but more importantly, how does that relate to the training and resources that we're doing? And then again, sprint number 3, after again, we built it, tested, soft launched it, right? We're creating real progression in what we're building and applying it to today. Right? What do we want to become, right? That's about the direction for us as an L&D function, how we'll get there, right? So you want to break these up into 90-day sprints that we can then work through so that again, what you as a group work on, we're also yielding insight, but also real value. That's the real powerful piece of this. And then again, ideally, and this is what it takes no matter what, once we built, activated, and think about this, each 90-day sprint, we're creating progression, we're creating buy-in, we're creating value, where we're building this identity that has real energy to it because we've been using it as we've been building it, right? Year 2 is about fully hardwiring and transforming what we then need to do org-wide business unit regions and team and people in respect of whether it's a rollout, whether it's org-wide and then we drill down, or like we've done with a lot of clients with teams and people and we roll our way up. But it's really creating a progression that really within, you know, that second year, we're not only rolling it out, but we're really helping people to fully hardwire this, make it a part of their business so that for them, their business unit and region and the organization, we're creating progression in that. So that's kind of the blueprint, not just high level, but pragmatically how you can leverage things today. So that's the working on it part. What do I mean in terms of working in it? And for obvious reasons with what we've been going through as a society, I started leveraging some of that for you now. What you want to always have here is this idea of first focus. So most importantly, it's about making sure that when we talk about building culture, even in this kind of situational way of creating strength and unity today, what are the mindsets we want people to have? What are the behaviors at the core, no matter what happens, we want to make sure to bring together? And what's the approach we want to take that can support how we as individuals and organizations operate against our shifting priorities monthly, quarterly, yearly? So what does that look like right now, right? In terms of the mindsets, behaviors, and approach that we want to bring everybody around so that everything we do helps to center around value for them. So again, while we're building something, what focus do we need to have now so that it supports that, right? The capability. So what improvements, decisions, and value creation, what is it we want to be able to build and activate now? So while we're going through this process, soft launching pieces, creating resiliency, creating strength, creating progression that will set us up for a future. What decisions do we want this to help us with today? If it's how we deal with remote work, how we get people connected, how will what we're building here, we're doing in a smaller format as I talked about, how will that help support us, right? And then results, going back to kind of these four cornerstones that we alluded to briefly in our session. And it's hard to do this right now, I understand that. What impact do we want with our marketplace right now? Maybe we don't know. Maybe it's a day-to-day, week-to-week thing. What value do we want to provide to our customers that really is going to help them well beyond what it is that our business is there to do for them, but we're a real partner for them? What does this mean in terms of our organization, maybe not growth right now, but our, again, our resiliency, our courage, our ability to stabilize as much as we can? What are those results? And what about in terms of not just retention and ownership, but optimization? So as we work on things on these 90-day sprints, or maybe it's monthly, right, based on everything going on, we want to establish a focus that everybody understands right now, the culture that we want to have while we're building it, right? Be the change we want to see in the world so that individually I can grasp it and start to be accountable to what it is we're building. Capability, what are the improvements and decisions that we want to make now so that what we're building for folks isn't, oh, that's what the L&D function or training function is doing. Yeah, I'm so busy right now. No, this is what it is we want to affect for you right now. And then the results, this is our commitment to what we're trying to impact. This represents, again, a focus that creates the immediacy of how what we're doing, even in these kind of uncertain times, not only is still needed, but we're using it to really impact today. You want to make sure on a quarterly, monthly, and weekly basis, not just to do training and classes and programs and how do we best do remote work. And we know from companies like Vital Smarts and LinkedIn Learning, a lot of great free value out there. You can just search on Google, right, and YouTube, be a ton of resources on that. But how do we make sure on a weekly, monthly, quarterly basis, we're giving people the permission and ability to have a voice in terms of, hey, what are some things that have really progressed well for you as you're working from home for you, your family, your team, and our business? What's not going well? What are you challenged by right now? Great. How does it relate to how you see not only your focus, but our collective focus? It could be just a department, could be org-wide, again, however you're set up to do. How does that shape how you feel we need to be focused? Where do you feel we most need to improve? And what support do you need so that you are still having as much as you possibly can right now? Confidence and resiliency, what do you need from us in support? If on a frequent basis, even in a huddle, weekly with your team, monthly if it's in all hands, quarterly, which now seems like 3 years from now, because we've only been dealing with this for 2 weeks, but what can you do in your frequency, not just in the types of training you're doing and what we want to do culturally, but how we connect those dots, as I just alluded to, so we're giving people a voice and a thread back to us so we can then share back with them. That is critical right now, that beyond what we work on, how we work in. And then lastly, in terms of follow through, we've got to think about what we do in training, how we ensure what we're doing, what we're helping people take action on, and the value we're getting back, insights and learning, so we're feeding. This is like a flywheel. We're not only giving to help them move forward, but we're asking for them to feed back to us, so we're moving forward. We want to own the narrative to always show how we are following through org-wide, business units and regions, and teams and people. We need to show people that we are connected, we are integrated, even in these times of change. So that is the blueprint for working on it and working in it. And we'll be sharing certainly more as we go forward here, especially with what's going on, to help you with this in support. So right now, what I'd like to be able to do is open up, because I know, again, Joe was able to at least tap a question. The chat window seems to be jumping in and out, but oh, wait a minute. Looks like we maybe did get some chat. Hold on a second. Looks like this is working. Perfect. Excellent. All right. So let's not jump into everything finally is working. Cool. All right. Questions. So we have about 10 minutes left. We're going to wrap up here in about 7 minutes or so, just with how we're going to support you. But please right now bring your questions. And even if I don't get a chance to answer them, I will share with you how you can at least submit stuff to us so we can at least still engage with you. So with that, please go to the Q&A button. What question do you have right now? What support do you need right now? Based on what I'm sharing, that is obviously still about the bigger future, but you can see very valuable in terms of how we can start to do things in the present. Please, if you have any questions. And questions could just be simply about, hey, I'm thinking about this right now and how do I go about supporting it? So I'll give some of you a moment by which to do that. Well, let me put it to you this way, just to maximize time here. How many, if you do have a question, raise your hand, just so I know if you're typing something right now. If you don't have a question, if there's not an idea you want support with real time in this community, we do have people raise their hand, great. You wanna type right in that Q&A button that you've got right on the bottom, your question so I can see that from you. So go ahead and do that now. Don't see anybody typing anything right now, although I did see a couple of you raise your hands. So again, want to be respectful of time, so I'll just give it another minute. While people are potentially typing, just to see if those that just raised their hand are doing so, let me just provide you some support and some thoughts here. So I did get a question. How do I start this right now in the midst of the shift from the coronavirus? So I think it's this idea that most powerfully, we want to create a sense of, again, owning the narrative. I'm not saying owning what's the headlines right now, but how we make sense of it, how we process it, how we go about both being informed and made and creating more intelligence and preparedness, but how do we make sure translate it? So what we want to do is we want to be able to go to our stakeholders. We want to say to them, we understand in these critical times, what's really critical is that we, as I said before, we maintain our confidence and capability. Right now, what we like to do as an L&D function is kind of really reach out and beyond classes and programs and modules from a technical aspect or a qualitative aspect, how we actually go about making sure that we can provide direction. As a result, this is what we would like to do. We would like to go ahead and reach out to folks and ask three questions. And I'm just giving this to you real time, right? What clarity would you like right now from the organization about how to best be better prepared? What do you need to build your confidence right now in how you can be better prepared and feel that you can really get ahead of this? And what are some concerns you need to solve? So clarity, confidence, concerns. Maybe the first thing is an L&D function that you put out there. That beyond any strategic questions, people need clarity, right? That's the biggest thing that's missing right now because there's headlines everywhere, right? Who's it coming from? What does it mean? You know, et cetera. And I can go for another hour just in examples of headlines that when you read deeper, wow, New York Times, why did you use that headline and what else is going on, right? People need clarity, people need confidence, they also need to have acknowledgement around their concerns. So the first thing that you could do is really be able to do that and really reach out to your key stakeholders and say, for the organization, for our departments and for our people, where do you feel we need greater clarity? Or what we say in our core approach, true clarity. Where do you feel we need to build confidence right now when it comes to the people, the teams in the organization? And what are some concerns you feel that are out there? And you be that feeder, you be that gatherer of that. So your first value is about really unlocking, integrating, and showing that. So that would be how I would answer that question first, among other things. Joe, by the way, asked that. So thank you, Joe, for prompting that. All right. So I don't see any questions that were typed. No problem. Let's then wrap up. So first things first, was this webinar of value to you today? Show of hands. Awesome, right? Because what's really critical for us is to really unlock what it means to work on and work in. And that even with what's going on today, identity is more important than ever. Show of hands, how many of you know of people right now that are more panicked than others? Just to give kind of a wrap-up example to this. Okay. Why is that? They're probably getting the same information. Forget their economic status or situation, right? It's how they're wired. It's how they think. It's the values that they have and the bigger way in which that they view the world. That's their values. That's their mission. That's their, right? Culture, same thing. We need culture more than ever, not in terms of just the act of culture, but the identity by which, coming from L&D, of to how we can be that partner that now is going to help us move forward, but how we progress forward in the present, right? So here's a wrap-up piece. You might recall my example with one of our clients, Bosch, when we did their big transformation last year, right? This whole unity, bigger purpose as an organization in support of how they can come together with all their different business units, all their different departments, to really think about the greater possibility of how they can partner with not just Silicon Valley, but the world as we are evolving and changing digitally, right? This was their purpose, vision, mission, values, and behaviors, just as a representation, right? So what I'm about to share with you is a quick video clip, and then we'll wrap up with how can we support you with next steps. In respect of, just as a way to kind of be inspired, how this idea of making life better, ... and every business unit and department, how do we all thread to making life better as a site so that we can look at all the things that we do, from autonomous driving to sensor technology to batteries, and how does that make life better? How do we want it to make life better? And through that, how does that, what does that mean for a site is how we collectively will make life better. And the big vision to support that is this idea of 1 + 1 = 11. I with my team member, my team with another team, so we can really support our bigger mission values. So as you watch this clip, I hope it inspires you, hopefully it connects to you, and then we'll wrap up.
To solve life's biggest challenges.
Our people are very special here because they bring passion to the work. They drive innovations forward.
To do what can only be done here.
Our culture makes life better.
Our associates make life better.
Our work makes life better.
Silicon Valley is all about talented and motivated people. It's about ideas, and it is about taking these moonshot ideas and making them happen. We have 200 plus really talented people trying to achieve the goals of the teams. Can we achieve something more than the sum of each of these teams? This is 1 + 1 = 11.
We are more valuable side by side.
I hope that was inspiring to you, because if you hear, you heard the who we are, the history, the background, what we want to be, how we're going to get there. So look at this and leverage this even right now in your situational way. So we can certainly be of help, whether it's virtually, certainly not in person today, but if there's any way that we can help you in regards to how to spin this up, even leveraging some targeted workshops to build the resiliency, the renewal, the overall focus and confidence of people, even in bite-sized ways, we're deploying a massive amount of work in that way. So in the work that we do, how do we do so virtually in bite-sized ways to support your efforts, your progression? So if we can be of help to you, or you just got some questions, please contact our support team at answers@thtresults.com. What is your question or need? Why is that really critical to you? And if you would like to set up a time to connect, when would you like to do that? If it's something you want some support in right now, you just have some things you want to bounce off us, we're more than happy to help you. If it's something that, no, I really do want to talk to you, but I'd like to set something a month or two from now in support, great. But we can be of help even if it's in small bite-sized ways. So on behalf of Joe and myself, I want to thank you. These are just some examples of specific things that we'll be sharing more about in terms of what we are putting forward to support the times that are now. But again, I want to thank you for your time. I want to thank you for your commitment. Please reach out to us via the email address I just gave before, just so that you can see, again, beyond these options of how we're supporting clients in our network and community today. answers@thtresults.com. And we look forward to connecting with you again. And some of you we do have appointments with, so we're looking forward to talking to you. And otherwise, Godspeed to all of us, and best health and best wellness. So thank you. Appreciate it. Have a great day.